What is up, Gunplum Modelers? This is Strider Prime bringing you a new edition of Gundam Models, and today I am going to build this kit. The 144 scale Real Grade Talgeese III from the Mobile Suit Gundam Wing Endless Waltz animated series slash movie. So I'll say this. I was pretty happy to get this little kit. Yes, really happy. I've always liked the Tallgeese 3, yes, everybody, and I'm assuming a lot of people has. And I look at people online who post their builds of the Tallgeese 3 Master Grade version, which is also a P-Bandai. And I have to say I'm a little jelly at the fact that I wish I had that. I wish I had this kit. I really do. And even though I do like my Tallgeese that I purchased years ago, and won third place in my in MosquitoCon, I've always did like the 3. And I know one day I was going to get my hands on it. But when this was announced as a Real Grade, I said, cool. I didn't jump through hoops to get the Real Grade version of the regular Tallgeese as much as I wanted to get it, but I said when I saw this and I saw, oh, I gotta pick this up. I really did. And I picked this up from Bluefin. This is the truth. I picked this up from Bluefin at a good price. And clearly, you know, you could always get it at all the places if you guys can't get it through Bluefin. I'm doing this on behalf of Gundam Planet, that also has a huge stock of the Tallgeese 3 if anyone's interested. And in the course of the series, I'll post a video, a link to the Tallgeese 3 on my videos. If you guys want to go out and pick it up, just click on the link. You'll get a little 10% discount for those of you who are interested in purchasing it. But yeah, Tallgeese 3 is one badass mobile suit. I've always liked the scenes from it from the movie. It really, really, you know, really got to me when I saw that. I did buy the high-grade version, which I tried to paint, and it was not, of course, the best build. And I bought a 1/100-scale version of it, not realizing that 1/100-scale version was already built. And I was like, ah, darn it. So I purchased a kit that was already built. Did not know that. But, yeah, I can't wait to build this little guy. Unfortunately, this kit is a P-Bandai, so you don't see all the detailed information that you normally see on the box, you know, what parts and things like that. So we'll definitely have to open it up and take a look at it. And as you can see, it's still in its plastic, brand new, spring spanking new. I hate to open it up, but we are going to open it up, of course. And since this is a custom series of build, I'm going to paint it as well. And I mentioned this before in my last video about a week ago, more than a week ago. I said, should I make this kit for GBWC or should I bring the Dynamis? Many people say I should bring the Dynamis because it's already built. While others say I should build this, and if I can't make it and finish it in time, bring your Dynamis to GBWC as well. So we're going to build it anyway. Because in all due fairness, I want to build something, you know, something cool. So, let's open this up. Before we open that up, let's read the things here. Real Grade is designed to recreate the real thing with fine details and an abundance of colored parts. Movable parts with the widest possible range of movement are equipped on the pre-assembled inner frame that it only requires cutting out. Real Grade offers the joy and excitement of building a mobile suit, the numerous gimmicks packed into the palm-sized 144 scale model for all generations of Gundam lovers. So I'm a Gundam lover. Alright. Ooh. Oh. Fancy schmancy. Hold on a second. I'm going to adjust the camera a bit so you guys can see this. So plate. What number is this plate? Plate A. We have a unique. We have a white inner frame. Now that's kind of cool. It's white. Then we have the white parts mixed with the blue parts. Clear part there. Alright. Alright, so now we have a very, very light brownish tan color of the darker parts, I'm assuming. Probably the inner frame parts. I see the thrusters here. These parts look like those, and I'm going based on how I remember the Master Grade version. This has to be from the backpack. So I do remember that. Beam Saber. And I mentioned, and I was hoping that maybe Bandai would throw a bone, but clearly we have stickers here, and we are not using any stickers at all. If I want to do this right, I want to get the water slide decals. I don't know if they made water slide decals for the Real Grade Talgeese, so that's something I'm going to have to look online. So, light tannish brown, but then over here we have the gray, a light grayish brown colors. Here's more, no, light gray, the darker brown. Okay. The blue, nice. This is plate I and plate G1, followed by B, or S, B, well, you know what I mean. We have the yellow part for the crest, the V-fin crest. Parts of the armor of the legs. That's very familiar, of course. That's shoulder armor right there. There's six marquees. Or peace crest. And then these are the parts that will be the connection for the whip that's on the shield. J plate and E2 plate. And I'm assuming the next bag that I'm pulling out is going to do the same thing, but it has extra parts here. That's the waist armor, or the skirt armor in the front. That's the part of the head. More blue parts. Oh wow, different set of hands. That's actually nice. That could be the holder for the cannon. And then we have more light gray parts for the backpack, I remember. And then we have a more light blue parts. That's for the head. That has to be for the head. And there's the chest armor. Skirt armor right there. C2. G2, the other one for them. I'm not going to go back over there. So there you go. And then here is the manual. Let's put this back here. Review the manual for a bit. Adjust the camera a little bit more. So there are some parts that are not required. We see some parts here on that plate on C2. On G1, I see a circular plate, and that was probably because of the shield that it had in the Tallgeese 1, the first Tallgeese. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 14, or somewhere between 14 or 15 parts are not required for this. So it's not like you're going to have a bag full of parts left over. That's kind of cool. And then we have the assembly of the legs itself right there. Very thinny. Gotta also remember that this kit is small. This is not a big kit like the new Gundam that just recently came out. So it will be, it's still bigger than the original Tallgeese 3, just, I'm sorry, Tallgeese 1 and 2, but it's still a smaller kit. So you're roughly, I don't have the Wing Gundam anymore, so it would have been nice to have that there. Alright, so that, here's the leg parts continuing on. Then we have the waist unit, so we're going from legs up. Here's the waist unit right there. So this is a little bit different because I think I remember there was one of these, but now you get two of these because double the thrusters, I guess. No, that's wrong, because that's the back part. I'm sorry, I thought these were two on the sides. That's two in the back. It's been a while. So the assembly of the waist. Then we have the assembly of the chest unit. That's kind of cool. All right. And then from there, the chest, you go from the assembly of the arms. Very articulate, cool armored parts there. Shoulder assembly there. And then the assembly of the head. And then the backpack verniers. And that's going to be very unique with all the smaller parts, especially the mechanism of it opening up and exposing the thrusters, like on the Master Grade version. I remember how difficult that was to put it together and opening it up and closing it. So hopefully I don't have the same problem with this guy. So with the two vernier packs already installed and set up, then you have to build the Mega Cannon, the weaponry set. So we have the Mega Cannon that goes on the right arm and has that attachment there, so that's kind of cool. And then how to open it up and expand it out. Then we have the shield, which is very small compared, well, maybe not that small, but it is round. It's not rounded like the other one. And then how to take off the beam saber hilt and attach it to the shield, and then from the shield attach it to the hands to use it as a weapon. And of course, the heat rod, which is the little thing that goes through. And I was looking at the packaging, and I'm glad that it's not like I remembered, because for those of you who remember the heat rod from the Epion, the Epion, those had parts connected to each and every part, and one of them broke. But this one, you have a wire going right through it, so this is even better, and I kind of like that. So I'm kind of pleased to see something like that. And of course, once it's assembled, here are the placement of decals, the stickers, of course, and of course, the ever so popular chart color chart, if you want. So it does show two types of white. It's just so subtle, you can barely see it. Well, you know what? With that being said, so this is what the kit looks like, you know, built and all that stuff. And I'm going to really enjoy this, but now let's talk about painting.